Babies require a lot of attention in order to stay alive, but when they're all wrapped up in a nice cozy blanket, they could be in a lot of danger. All you nurturing parents out there, Katie Wayne here for D News. Infants are adorable. I don't know that there are many people who could, in all honesty, disagree. But something else that we all agree on is that they are a huge responsibility. Keeping another human alive is no cakewalk. In fact, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, approximately 4,000 infants die suddenly and unexpectedly. This is often attributed to sudden infant death syndrome, or SIDS. SIDS is defined as a sudden death in an infant under 1 year old that cannot be explained after a thorough investigation is conducted. A thorough investigation includes an autopsy, an examination of the death scene, and a review of the infant's medical history. This is obviously a very scary thought for expecting and new parents, that your baby could just die for no apparent reason. But according to a recent study conducted by the National Institute for Child Health and Human Development and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, among other institutions, nearly 50% of American infants sleep with unsafe bedding that can increase the risk of SIDS. Unsafe bedding, by the way, includes loose blankets, toys in the crib, pillows, quilts, you get the idea. These objects increase the risk of SIDS and accidental suffocation. The recommended way to put a baby to sleep, according to the NICHD, is to place the baby on its back on a firm, safety-approved mattress with a fitted sheet. And that is it. No extra bedding, no unmonitored swaddling, no baby toys, nothing on top of or under the baby, a detail that the researchers report escapes many new parents. To keep the baby warm, you can dress them in layers so you can remove or add clothing as needed. Keep the room at a comfortable temperature, and in winter, if the baby is not yet crawling, you could use a space heater. There are also these adorable baby sacks. They're like sleeveless dresses with the bottom sewn closed so that it mimics the sensation of being swaddled or a blanket, but doesn't pose a risk of suffocation. And they're loose around the hip, so there's no risk of inhibiting hip development, something that swaddling can do. But you do need to think about overheating, because contrary to popular belief, babies don't need any more warming than adults. Now, to be fair, the researchers also believe that new parents are given a lot of mixed information. Many magazines aimed at women of childbearing age contain images of infants with lots of cozy blankets and pillows. This could easily reinforce the impression that obeying your desire to keep your baby cozy and warm with blankets is not only normal, it's the best way to go about things. Unfortunately, that's just not the case. But fortunately, now you know. Thanks for joining me on D News, guys. And if you'd like to see more D News, please subscribe. And if you'd like to know what I'm up to, you can always follow me on Twitter @Katie Wayne or on my YouTube channel, A New Hope, with 3 E's. I'll see you next time.